Good day, learners. This is Easy Engineering. This time, we're going to talk about motion along a straight line, free fall. Whenever you drop a stone from a third floor building, it falls straight to the ground. This is an example of a free fall motion. Whenever object falls to the ground, we can say that the object is in free fall. This is caused by gravitational force. Today, let us examine this kind of motion. The subject of this motion is the stone. So, we give our attention to the stone. Initially, you are holding a stone. We can say that the stone is at rest. Hence, the initial velocity of stone is equal to 0 meters per second. At initial time, 0 second. When you let go of the stone, and right before the stone hit the ground, the stone now possesses its final velocity at time it takes to travel, covering the distance from the third floor of the building to the ground. Again, at first, the velocity of stone is 0 meters per second, and right before it hits the ground, it possesses some value of velocity. We can simply say that the stone is accelerating. In free fall, the free-falling object accelerates towards the Earth, and this acceleration is due to gravitational force of the Earth, which is denoted by small letter g. Using few mathematical equations, we derive from the equation of G as, now the capital letter G is the universal gravitational constant, which is equal to, and the capital letter M is the mass of Earth, which is equal to, and the capital letter R is the radius of the Earth, which is equal to. So, substituting the known values, we can get the value of the small letter G, which is equal to 9.8 meters per second squared. Do you know what is interesting? This value of g is not dependent of the object's mass. From the equation, it is dependent only to the mass of the Earth and the radius of the Earth. It has nothing to do with the size or mass of the object. Why is this interesting? Now let me give you this as an example. Suppose you're standing, you're holding on your left hand a stone, and on your right hand a paper. You drop them together at the same height. The question is, which object reaches the ground first? Yes, you are right. The stone will reach the ground first. But how about if you crumple and squeeze the paper and drop them together at the same height? The question is, which object reaches the ground first? Well, the answer is, both objects will reach the ground at the same time. You can try it at home to validate what you've seen in the video. Because again, what governs a free-falling object is the gravitational acceleration, which is constant if you are here on Earth, and g is not dependent on object's mass. In the previous example, the reason why the paper falls behind the stone is because of the air resistance. If you eliminate the air resistance, which we did in the second example, the paper now falls together with the stone. That is all for now. I hope you learned something today. Once again, this is Easy Engineering.